Indialippines channel.
Hello guys,
welcome back to Team Indialippines channel, and for our new viewers, welcome to
Team Indialippines family.
So today's video is
about us getting married in the church.
We got married twice.
So we got married in the church October 1st and October 27th we got married in the embassy, because as per UAE law you need to get married in the embassy to make it legal, and if you're not married in UAE you cannot live together.
Yeah, that's true, or else you will go to jail. So guys, we are doing this video especially to our friends who are messaging us and to other people who wants to get married. I used to receive a lot of messages asking how to get married, what are the documents, how you process everything, something like that.
Yeah.
So did you experience maybe?
No, nobody asked me about it because I don't know. No one asked me. I think maybe they are asking you because you know the girls, they want to know what is happening about this.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah, maybe.
Actually the most both of the marriages, both of the occasions in church and in the embassy, it was it is tedious and time consuming, but more in the embassy because it's more complicated to get married in the embassy. So before you plan about the church wedding, you have to go to the embassy and talk about it and get to know what has to be done. We will explain it in our next video, because we did church wedding first. We are going to talk about church wedding.
Yeah, so before we start, please watch our wedding in the church. Ta-da!
This time, tonight I'll be She's there to mend it. Maybe my vow's weaker than splendid, but I try again. Oh Lord, all over again for you. Love, oh, won't you come? Love, oh, won't you come? Marry me tonight. Love, oh, won't you come back to me?
October 1st, 2016. It's 2016. 2016. So like 111 something something like that. Okay, so what we did, baby?
So when that was happening, I mean before our wedding, I was in Qatar visiting my sister, and we discussed about getting married and everything, and so this particular thing is specifically for Christians and Catholics. So what we do basically before getting married is the pre-marriage course.
Yeah, pre-marriage course.
It's very important that you do the pre-marriage course. If you don't do it, you will not be allowed to get married in the church. So I did it in Qatar and she did it here in Dubai. So you have to do the pre-marriage course first, and prior to that, after that, you will have to go to the church and talk about your interest of getting married. And apart from that, you will need witnesses during the time of marriage, somebody who can be a witness for you. And next thing is fixing a date.
Yes.
So depending on the crowd, they will ask you whether you want the big cathedral or basilica or church, or you want a small chapel, and you fix a date. And there's another thing which is required is you got the letter from your church in Payete, right?
Yeah. So what are the documents required? What are the documents they required us to submit in the church?
They wanted all the documents.
Yeah, but first, of course, the most important thing is birth certificate.
Yeah.
First one is the birth certificate of me and him.
Baptism certificate.
Senumar in Philippines, that is the certificate of non-marriage.
Yeah.
Okay, so, and if you are 25 or below 25, you need an affidavit. I did that because that time I was only 24 years old. So, I think they asked
for approval from your parents,
parents,
right?
And affidavit.
Yeah. So, you know, Filipinos, they want approval from parents. And for me, I was on the proper age, and apart from that, they wanted my baptism certificate, I don't know, birth certificate also, I believe. I think my dad did all the job when he was in India. And yes, you need a certificate from your church stating that you're allowed to get married or you're not.
And confirmation.
Confirmation certificate.
Yeah, confirmation certificate. So for me, what they required is birth certificate, senumar, legal capacity or affidavit from your parents that they are allowing you to get married, and what do you call this one? Baptism, and the certificate of confirmation. It should be all attested.
All attested in terms, I mean, I don't think you need it attested.
No, I did it.
You did it, but for me, it was not required. They just wanted the original document from the church.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we have the document.
Yeah, we have the documents here. So we have this folder. I'm going to show you.
Full of documents.
Full of documents. Oops.
So if you're going to get married, buy a big file.
Yeah, buy a big file. All our legal documents, everything, Chuchay's birth certificate, everything is here in this folder. So no need to grab, like, you know, search where we put all the documents. It's just all here. So what we have is, okay,
this and our register.
So this
first is, you show the confirmation or birth certificate or anything, report of marriage. No,
consulate, Rachelle Ann. So this is the legal capacity.
Yeah, show it to them.
So this is the legal capacity. Okay, I will just put the screenshot of this. So legal capacity, we have the legal capacity. So this is what is written.
Yeah, to certify Ms. Rachelle Ann Lopez, born sole holder of Philippines passport, 24 years old, by virtue of her sworn statement and the documents she submitted to this office, and there being no information that she possesses any disqualification to contract marriage under the laws of Philippines. The Philippine Consulate General hereby grants the certificate of legal capacity to contract marriage. This is to certify that based on documents submitted, you have to submit the documents of the guy too, because my name is also included in this. She intends to marry Mr. Varun Varghese Harry, Indian national. After contracting marriage, the marriage certificate should be authenticated by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of the host country where the marriage took place. Afterwards, the marriage should be reported to the Philippines consulate, which has consular jurisdiction over that country. The certificate is valid for 120 days from the date of issuance and may be used anywhere in the United States.
United Arab Emirates.
Sorry, United Arab Emirates.
I wish we are in US.
I mean, I was watching a video about United States, so I think. So this is already expired.
Yeah.
So it's done.
So this legal capacity is only valid for 3 months if you are planning to get married. Yeah, so that's what all we have. So guys, in the church, I think we don't have such an issue. Like, we don't have so much pressure about the documents. But anyway, guys, first, you need to think about if you want to get married. For example, the same like me and him. If you are here in UAE, if you want to get married, please process your document fast, as soon as possible.
Yeah.
Right? If it is coming from Philippines, ask whoever is in Philippines, maybe your mother or your sister. Because what I did is, I asked my mom to process everything for me. So, she sent me the birth certificate. No, I already have it.
And she had to go to Manila many times.
Right? Yeah, she had to go to Manila many times. It's really a hassle for her. And it takes a lot of time. I think 2-3 weeks when you were in Qatar.
I don't know how long.
Yeah, so I think it takes 2-3 weeks for me to receive all the documents I need from my mom. Ayon. So, for you, baby.
India is much closer, so someone was going up and down. I think my parents came down by the time, because for the church wedding they were already here, right?
Yeah.
And see, the documentation part of the church, yeah, you need in Philippines, for the Filipinos or any nationalities who are staying here, you need to process it as soon as possible. Different embassies have different requirements. So Filipinos are very strict in, I mean, embassy is very strict in getting the documents done. So you need time. Some document took almost a month, right? I think that red ribbon attested document, something like that. That comes in the next video.
No, that is all the same. Because what happened is, whatever documents, most of the documents church required to us is also required to the Indian embassy.
So you need to understand that both of the embassies require all the documents of whoever you are getting married to. The Philippines embassy has to see who she is getting married to, and my passport, visa and everything has to be provided. And I mean, if you are outside the country, the most important thing in a church wedding is that for a girl is the dress. She got her dress from Philippines.
Yeah.
And shoes also from Philippines, I think.
One more thing, I have an additional. So when we are processing the document, so we already gave everything to the church. So what they did is, they posted our picture on their bulletin board. You remember?
Yeah, they put, I mean, they posted the information.
Information that me and him are trying to get married. So we are getting married so that if people will see, like whoever will, what do you call this one?
I mean, if somebody has any kind of rejection or something to say about our wedding, so they can come to the church and say it.
Yeah, that's true. So you have three weeks to post that banner.
Yeah.
Wedding banner.
So the wedding will only happen after 3 weeks. So you need to plan in advance.
3 weeks.
So when you start processing the documents, at least 3 to 4 months in advance, you have to think of a date.
That's true.
Yeah.
So what happened to us is, he proposed to me by July or June? I think June or July whatsoever. And then that day itself, I went to the church. He went to the church. He asked about pre-marriage course. whatsoever, and then ask about the documents. What are the documents? We ask what all we need. So I will also post here what is in the church website, what are the requirements, so you guys will not get confused.
Yeah.
Right? So
that's it. Part one is finished. Anything else you have to say?
Well, for me, I think if you guys want to get married, first, of course, you need to get married in the church if you are Catholic. I don't know who else can get married in the church if they are not Catholic. Hindu can do get married.
No, if you convert, anybody can get married.
So, guy can convert, Hindu or no?
I don't know, because I really don't know.
Okay.
I mean, conversion and all that, it's another formality which you have to check with the church.
Yeah, but for us, the thing is, we are both Christians, so we didn't face any issue. When we asked, because he is a Latin Catholic and I'm Roman Catholic, we didn't face any issue that time.
They didn't bother about it because obviously after getting married, you will turn into the guys. Mm-hmm. I mean, even if you are Roman.
And also, you know, and also... Chucha is playing. And also what happened that time is that we pick our own priest.
Yeah, we can.
Yeah, that time we pick our own priest who will...
So they will give you choices, right?
Yeah, they will give you choices. In the church, here in Dubai like that, they will give you the list, whoever will, who will be the available priest on that day. So you can pick. And then you can pick songs.
Yeah, we can pick songs.
We can pick songs. And then, what else? The venue, because there's a small chapel, there is also a big, the main church. So you can pick wherever you want to get married, whether in the small or the big one. And what
else?
We
did it in the big one.
Yeah, we did it in the big one.
So we had people coming over, so. Mm-hmm. I think more than 20 people, you will have to do it in the big one. If it is less than 20 people, you will have to do it in the small chapel.
Yeah. So our wedding is amazing. It's it's not typical Filipino wedding because it's mixed. So you can see on that video that there is Filipino, Indian, the bride's, what do you call it, groomsmaid?
Okay, you can see that.
Ayon. So that's all, guys, for our wedding wedding videos. I mean, wedding, how we process, how we get married in the church. So you need to say anything else, baby?
Nothing. You can see more in our part 2 where we got married in the embassy.
Okay. So keep on watching, guys. Click the next video. We will talk about
embassy wedding.